With magnets, you can snap it here, or here, or anywhere. Almost anywhere.
This is my review of the new Insta360 GO 3, and how does it compare to the GoPro 11? Which one has more bang for the buck? Let's find out. I'm Benchminky from Authentech, and this video is not sponsored by Insta360. While they did provide me with this early sample unit, this is my authentic review. There's plenty of pros and cons to both sides. First, let me start with the pros, the things I like on the GO 3. That uber small size is just super fun. It's lightweight, it's ultra portable, it could be mounted in so many itty bitty spaces that any other camera couldn't normally fit in. Plus, its mounting system, I really like it. It's fast, it's secure, it's easy to mount just about anywhere.
For mountability, the GO 3 wins big time. Check this out. Not only do you got the snapping options, but bam, it just clips right into that little mount system. I love it. Good old GoPro. Well, you gotta unscrew this thing, pull it out, pop out the fingers, slide them in, manually alignments. Come on, where's the magnets? Screw this thing in, 10 minutes later, you gotta ratchet down super tight, rip off some flesh, spin it around, and yeah, I'm gonna take the magnets and that quick snapping system any day.
Now, while the GO 3 camera is almost the same size as the previous generation GO 2, it's just a tiny bit larger, and in return, we get longer battery life and higher resolution. It jumps up from 1440p up to 2.7K, and I'm just like you, I get those confused all the time, so here's a handy chart of comparison. While it's still not 4K, which is a bit of a bummer, it being so tiny, I sort of understand. And on that note of battery life, it's 50% longer than the previous GO 2 when standard. Alone. Then when it's placed inside that new charging dock, it can reach up to 170 minutes. Now I honestly clearly noticed this major improvement right away, as that battery life seems to last quite a long time. And then when I was out shooting versus the GoPro, well, the GoPro drained so much faster. Oh, and I also really like, whenever I pop the camera back into that case, it automatically recharges the camera, so it's always a full battery each time we pop it out to go film.
Comparing screen brightness, I actually think the GO 3 is just a little bit brighter than the GoPro. I like that.
Another cool difference, yeah, GoPro's got the dual screen, but it's not touchscreen and it's small. I kinda like the GO 3 pop-up screen, kinda like you'd get with a mirrorless or a fancier camera. That's where you can see yourself, vlog mode, change settings, it's a bright screen. I like that. And it flips down for the rear. It's kinda cool.
And this is an audio test. I'm zipping down at the lake. It's pretty windy right now. This is audio on the Insta360 GO 3. And this is audio on the GoPro 11. How does the audio sound and compare on each?
Well, I think the GO 3's audio has improved from the previous model, and it now has two built-in microphones. However, in this wind test, the GoPro just sounds much better. One of the biggest comparisons in my mind when trying to determine which is the better action camera, I'm looking at video quality and sharpness, the HDR clarity, and then which has the better stabilization while maintaining a wider field of view. I will admit, when I was trying to match these up with same settings and everything, it felt impossible at times. The GoPro 11 can record up to 5K resolution, and all that stabilization is processed in the camera. The GO 3, it has a lot of different modes as well, just a lot less of resolutions and frame rates and things like that. When we compare the footage on a smaller screen, well, you might not even notice the resolution differences. I'd say the GO 3 can often look pretty good. If you pixel peep though, or you're viewing on a TV or a larger screen, well then you should probably spot the differences. There's two main different video modes on the GO 3 that you should know about. The built-in camera stabilization mode, which they just called video mode, or there's the flow state stabilization in post, which unlocks that 360 horizon lock, and you can adjust the aspect ratio without cropping in, even some minor reframing to tweak the shooting angle. However, that's called free frame mode, and it's at 1440p resolution. The standard video is up to the 2.7K. And also another layer of slight confusion, you can adjust the three levels of built-in stabilization here, level 1, 2, or 3. While I appreciate the customization, it sort of can get a bit confusing sometimes. This here is the GO 3 standard video mode on level 3 versus the GoPro's 5K hyperview, which looks much wider field of view, but not half bad on the GO 3, maybe even smoother looking. Let me know which one you guys are liking better so far down in the comments. Then this is the Go 3 free frame mode versus GoPro. Can you guys tell the resolution difference? I'll vote the GoPro still looks wider angle, but as for stabilization, I think the Go 3 wins again.
Go, baby, go! You said bald.
Let's go.
Woo, let's go. All right, we're putting in the hard work for you guys. You better smash that thumbs up for, hit that thumbs up for all that A+ effort.
Then I personally wanted to see the differences between my iPhone 14 Pro ultra wide camera versus the Go 3.
This is the 2.7K on the Go 3 with the level 3 built-in stabilization and standard video mode. And then this is 4K 30, just a standard ultra wide video on the iPhone.
I'd vote the iPhone 4K looks just a tiny bit sharper, but not by much, and just a hair wider angle, but better stabilization on the Go 3.
Now, this is action mode on the iPhone with the ultra wide angle, so it crops in quite a bit. It's also lower resolution at 2.8K, so how does it look and compare versus the Go 3?
Very interestingly, here the stabilization looks very close tie, iPhone stepping up its game, but the Go definitely wins for keeping the wider angle.
So check this out, I'm scooting along, I got the camera mounted on the bike, facing back at me, and then I can come to a stop, and just as easily go like this, pull it out, be showing you, hey, check out this sweet X260, this is like my favorite. And then for a third position, I can just go ahead and boom, snap it onto the magnetic pendant, and then zip off and away. We got Chesty mounted on Dalton on the dirt bike, and check this out with the remote viewfinder. We can frame it up so that we know it looks perfect. Don't need to pull out the phone or anything. That's sweet. Hit it. Range isn't too far. I'm not sure if it's using Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, but let's see if it reconnects when it's here. Hey, there we go.
How'd she look?
That's very cool. It disconnected too far, not too far away. Now I know to tilt her up.
Tilt it up more?
Yep. She was tilted down a little bit too much. Okay. Yeah, that's probably good. And then when you go ahead and lean forward, do that posture. Yeah, there we go. That looks good.
Had to snap a few quick photos and compare the two, and a few things that I noticed. The GoPro's looking much wider angle. If we zoom in on these, you should be able to see that sensor and resolution differences. The GoPro's just looking quite a bit sharper. The HDR and colors and contrast aren't bad on the Go 3. And just for fun, I snapped an iPhone ultra wide angle shot, and just check out the sharpness comparison. iPhone is looking quite a bit sharper than the Go 3. Now for the record, I don't think I ever really recommend capturing high-end photography with your action camera. I love a good hyperlapse comparison, and here you can see that both of them are doing a really nice job with good stabilization. Now, I do like how the Insta360, I can actually change the speed ramping after the fact. So if I want a little bit faster or slower, I can do that. With the GoPro, of course, it's sort of locked into the file. Both of them are looking very ultra wide angle. The blues in the sky on the Go 3 look even a little bit more saturated, which I like. Now onto a few cons I found for the Insta360 Go 3. There's quite a few silly limitations to be aware of when you have a camera system like this. For example, the time lapses, they need to be viewed in the app. We can't even play back on the screen itself. This is the same for a few other camera modes like slow motion, time shift, and hyperlapse. I think it's because all that processing is done later on your computer or your phone, I'm not exactly sure, but just something to know. When comparing the GoPro in terms of resolutions and frame rates, well, the Go 3 just massively falls short. I mean, the GoPro 11 just does an incredible job of offering an insane amount of concoctions. The ultimate mixtures of frame rates and resolutions and stabilization modes. And let's be honest, there's so many people who won't even consider buying the Go 3 just because it doesn't have 4K video. And then lastly, there's no removable or expandable SD card. Now there's three models of the Go 3 that you can buy. Here's the sizes and the prices. With the GoPro 11, it's often on sale around the same price of $400. That makes the two very close in price. I will say that the Go 3's form factor, it opens up a new world of shooting perspectives and angles that a standard GoPro might never capture. I honestly find it a bit more fun actually shooting with the Insta360, but it all depends on your use case. Links down below if you want to learn more. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see subscribers in my next one.